Hello, lovely people. So today I will speak about what Tantra is not. So for sure, Tantra is teaching about love. For me, Tantra is to learn how to love better and doing it. One of the main things in Tantra is important is that you free yourself from the peak orgasm, especially men, from the ejaculatory orgasm, but women as well from the clitoral orgasm, because she also lose energy through the clitoral orgasm and she stay addicted from the sex. But with men it's especially this is the case. The ejaculatory orgasm make you addicted from sex, make you desiring from sex. So any Tantra teachings what doesn't require from the students working on non-ejaculation techniques, on sublimating the energy, bringing it to the higher chakras, and staying basically addicted from ejaculation, staying addicted from sex, I would say it's not Tantra. Here I draw line, yes? And actually I like that people will realize that if you like to teach Tantra, if you like to share Tantra, you have to start with these basics. Because if you just teach beautiful techniques like slowness, intimacy, but the person still stay addicted from sex, it still run on desires, the person may use these beautiful techniques, slowness, intimacy, sensuality, looking into someone else's eyes, giving the melting hug. All those beautiful techniques, the person can use it for their own desires. So I see a lot of people just touch this part of Tantra, like eye gazing and so, and especially the men become professional fuck boys. They do it very slowly, very intimate, and the women love it, of course, because suddenly, you know, it's not the just fuck boy who is only about fucking. Yes, they are about fucking as well, but with the eye gazing. And when the person is addicted, it's still doing everything for the desire, for the, hey, I want to fuck in the end. It's just got beautiful tools to make the woman more happy. What, it's not bad in the end, but this is not Tantra. Tantra is about love making in the purpose of growing together, staying together as long as possible, not just changing one partner from the other and leaving the woman behind with broken hearts. From the normal fuckboy, it's no problem for the woman. Ah, yeah, he was anyway bad in bed and so. But from the like professional fuckboy who can last longer but still is addicted from the ejaculation, broken heart, it's a bit stronger. And to heal yourself from that, it's sometimes even more difficult than just from normal fuckboy. Yes, to forget such a beautiful, heart-touching lover, heartbreaking can be more severe. And I see there are beautiful guys around who looking into the eyes of the woman in beautiful ways and so on and so on. And I see them and every time with another woman, they don't even wish for any deeper relationship. So yes, it's very nice, but some of those women will feel hurt and left behind. This is not Tantra. Unhappy people behind. There is also another type of so-called spiritual gurus who are teaching and achieving some spiritual experiences, and they sing a lot of mantras, they teach a lot of mantras, they teach about Hindu goddesses and gods, and if they are not teaching the non-ejaculation techniques, that they produce the guys with the stuck up their nose who bypass spiritually their wounds
they cover a lot of layers on the top, and they are still sexually addicted from sex, so they are still keep on going, and they use their power of their knowledge, their power of whatever, they misuse it for their sexual desires. So you give them very powerful tools, but if you don't teach them the basics to not to be addicted from the ejaculation, then they misuse their tools for the purposes what are not leaving the, again, the woman's happy behind. So yes, this is also like the line for the Tantra teachers, Tantra schools. If you are sharing Tantra, start from the beginning, from the basics. Non-ejaculation, non-desiring from sex, freedom. So that's what is very important. I share a lot of information, how not ejaculate, how to free yourself from the peak orgasm, from the clitoral orgasm, and how to go higher with your Tantra. Whatever you will choose, if you do any work, even if you would call it non-Tantra, but you work with the sexuality, you should start from the freeing yourself from the sexual addiction. Otherwise, you may abuse your power. You may become another fucked up masseur who is fucking around and, yes, leaving the woman's behind, sometimes very unhappy and very hurt, very abused. So this is not Tantra. This, it breaks reputation and name of Tantra. So yes, call it erotic massage or call it whatever, but don't call it Tantra. So that's my way of feeling. Thank you very much for your attention.
Tulku.